Thanks everyone for joining. So this call is about Frappe Cloud. In the earlier session, we have discussed in ERP Next, since ERP Next is an open source solution, many companies who basically decide to use an ERP solution, especially ERP Next, all we need to do is find a server, let's host ERP Next there, and we are done. Right? We are completely independent control over back end, front end. We don't have any tie-ups with any third party or organization. We have complete freedom in all the sense. But that's not the thing, right? And there are lots of moving component and dependencies. Be it any ERP solution for that matter, there are many moving parts, right, which needs to be taken care of. So this is just a snippet from one of the earlier presentation of Roshab, that when you say self-hosting of ERP solution, it's not that simple. You have to figure out which OS, right, it's Ubuntu, which Ubuntu, like which Linux, Ubuntu, CentOS or what. You have a DNS problem, so you have to basically do stuff for that separately. Bench, like what is bench? We were talking about ERP Next. Then you have SSL thing, you have supervisor going up, you have supervisor going down all the times. You have Nginx problem, you have MariaDB problems, right? So there are so many moving parts which actually needs to be supported. You have to maintain backups, at times you have to restore it and whatnot, right? And when it comes to upgrading, you know, there are new set of problems. What is your current version? And then you have customizations which are outside ERP Next application, and how do we maintain that? Where are those applications? And you are like kind of then locked into your own system. Eventually, what people think that we won't be locked in if we don't have any dependencies or parties supporting our instance or taking care of it. And after a point, we realize that we are locked into our own system. So that's quite a few problems. I mean, not very few, but yeah, we got a solution for this. We got Frappe Cloud. And what it does is basically, you have to self-host ERP Next. Well, good enough. You have security concerns. We completely understand that. So we have a solution which is completely catering to your hosting needs. Right. So what ERP Next does is basically it's a server management tool for ERP Next and Frappe applications. If you want to run in ERP Next on a dedicated server, you can come to Frappe Cloud and create your instance on a dedicated server. And not just that, if you have additional Frappe applications, you can also host them on the Frappe Cloud itself and hook it up with your ERP Next account. So that's all possible. And you can create multiple ERP Next instances from a single view. So you don't have to basically run through the command prompts and bench start, bench stop, and you know, switch sites and nothing of that sorts. It's completely UI driven. You can create multiple ERP Next site, and we'll quickly jump into demo. So you'll see that soon. And yeah, as I mentioned that you can maintain and add your custom Frappe apps from the UI itself. So that has been also taken care. Aditya will add more on that. Then some of the features specifically about Frappe Cloud, that it's completely UI driven. If you want to, let's say, set a custom domain for your ERP Next instance, you don't have to go into command prompt and edit your etc host file with via Vim, or if you have to restore a backup of your ERP Next instance, you don't have to run it through the command prompt. It's all UI driven with monitoring tools as well, and it's absolutely viable. So whatever we do at Frappe Cloud, you get pay as you go option, pay as much as you use. And when we say use, it's basically measured based on the CPU time, right? So let's say if you are using ERP Next, and if you have say 5 users who are using ERP Next for 8 hours. So that's not CPU hours, because that's how some of the users took it. What CPU hours literally means is basically, let's say if I'm a user, and let's say if I want to check my profit and loss report. So I go to system and click on profit and loss report. And the server takes say 2 to 3 seconds for populating data and giving me that report. So that's the meaning of CPU hours. Those 2-3 seconds which it has consumed for giving me that report is what is going to be counted, right? So in a day, if you are working out working throughout the system, of course it depends. There could be few users, but CPU time can be more. There can be many users, but CPU time can be less. It takes into account your background job. So considering that in mind, we have kept our pricing plan very affordable.
For every site which is active for one day, we charge you for that one day. So for example, if there is a $30 site and it is active for one day, we'll charge you $1. And we accumulate this amount, and then at the end of the day, your card will be charged that amount.
So let's just say if you have 10 sites for 10 of your customers, your card will be charged for those.
So we'll quickly run you through the Frappe Cloud demo. It's up and live at frappe.cloud. If someone wants to check, create an account, create a site for yourself, it's up and running there. Quickly jump to my setup. This is my site wherein I have created some custom sites already, right? If you want to create a new site, all you need to do is click on new site, set a subdomain, which is pretty standard as we have on erconnects.com, right? frappepartners.frappe.cloud becomes URL of your site. Here you have apps. I want Frappe, I want erconnects, but which version of erconnects, we can also choose that. Like version 13 is pretty much beta now. Let's say I want to go with a stable version, version 12. Create site from backup. You already have a backup, say, a site of your customer on a dedicated server, on a client server, but now you are migrating them to Frappe Cloud. So while creating site itself, you can basically link the database backup files of your customer site or your own site. As soon as site is created, the backup will also be restored. And so that functionality is also there. If you want to restore a backup, you can check this, otherwise you uncheck it. Choose a suitable plan. Here there are recommendations based on concurrent user, right? You want to enable backup, you want to enable uptime monitoring. Good to go. Create a site. So it's creating, it's doing all of that. Create a new site, install Frappe, install erconnects into that site, in Frappe into that site. It's all happening in the backend, but we don't need to worry about it. We are getting all status updates right here. So while it's doing that, maybe I can quickly switch to one of my existing site. Okay, so this is the site which I created a few days back, Frappe Gadgets.Frappe Cloud. So UI from here is pretty much standard. I select the language, I select the country, I set the my credentials and everything, which is pretty much standard as you get into when you create a site from erconnects.com or from a self-hosted site. But once site is created, you get to see which all apps are installed on that site. Do you want to add a domain or redirect for your site? You can do it right from the UI. Again, no need to touch your command prompts or terminals. You want to download a backup, just click on schedule backup and you'll have a latest backup being downloaded with a link here. You want to change the site configuration, the email configuration, email server. It's all easily customizable from the UI. You want to drop this site? Yes, you can easily drop it. Access control, you want to access it as an admin, and what all the log of jobs which ran on this site. Right, so it's all available from the UI. So this site is now active, frappe.cloud. Okay, so this is about it. And also, let me quickly introduce, we went live with this few hours back, frappe.cloud. So do check this site and you'll get to know more about it. What is Frappe Cloud and why did we do this? What are the features of Frappe Cloud? What are the pricing? What are the pricing plans we have? Quickly, I'll also highlight. You have a provision to create your own profile, and you can also add your billing details and stuff. Right, so you can have your debit credit card being saved in place, so your billing will be taken care of. That's it from my side. Before I open it up to audience, I'll request if Aditya wants to add, if I miss something and you want to complete it, please come in. And so Aditya, guys, he's the creator of Rapid Cloud.
Yeah, hi everyone. Like, so this was, I mean, pretty much like that was like perfect presentation. So I think I'll go to the chat and see some of the questions. So we are actually trying to push something called a server script. That is like the recently added feature in version 12. So server script is something that lets you do everything an application, a custom application does without actually having to write a custom application. So it's pretty much like how client scripts lets you do client-side customization. You can do the same stuff with, you can run your custom reports now, write it written in Python. You can also add custom HTTP endpoints. And you can write your custom events. You can also schedule those events, schedule these scripts to run like background jobs. So pretty much everything that an app does, we are allowing people to do through server scripts. We'll also write a small documentation saying how, once you have an, if you already have an app, how do you convert this app to custom scripts so you don't actually have to manage the updates and everything. So right now, no, we are not actually allowing custom apps. We're pushing something else that does exactly the same thing. Then there's a question from Alperen. How much CPU time is needed for one user using ERP Next 8 hours a day? So it's pretty difficult to say that number out loud. And the reason that is because, well, it's not really, see, not all sites are the same. And even on all sites, not all requests are the same. You know, a general ledger report is much, much different from someone just opening the to-do list. Right. Also, the frequency of opening new links and everything. So it's really, really difficult to see how much CPU time is needed.
So there is no silver bullet question answer to this.
Yeah.
There's no formula we can implement. Yeah.
So one of the like starting points is essentially like whatever you think you're actually paying your outside hosting right now. Say DigitalOcean, if you're paying $20, start with $20 plan. Right. Start with an equivalent plan. That will pretty much work out for you. If it doesn't, then you can always change your plan, and then you don't actually have to worry about upgrading and anything. Then Mohammed asks again, what is the rule of the CPU usage rate? So here is the thing. So every time, like Omar said, right, every single request you make actually will add to your CPU usage. Most of the requests are done in like several milliseconds, so 10 milliseconds, sometimes 100 milliseconds, like very, very large reports. Might take a few seconds. And the way we do that is we already have some mechanisms inside Frappe that lets us count how long each request took. We just put that into a log file and then sum it up for the day. And that's how we essentially count how much CPU usage you have done. But right now, we are not actually billing you based on CPU usage. The way we are billing you is how many days your site was actually active on that plan. So if you are using, say, $30 plan and your site was active 30 days, then we are going to bill you $30. If your site was active 10 days, we're going to bill you $10. What that $30 plan will mean, though, is you won't be able to use more CPU than what is allocated to you. So if $30 plan lets you do, say, 2 hours a day, and that's all you will be able to use. Everything else, everything above that quota will actually drop. So right now in the starting phase, right, we're actually like pretty lenient policy. So even though the plans say one hour a day, we're actually allowing slightly like significantly more than that. So as to we'll understand exactly what exactly people are asking for. And then eventually as we move on, say after a few months, we'll make the bounds pretty strict.
But can we see how much is the CPU usage?
Right. So essentially, I'll show you a screen. Okay. So let's just say I'll log out and go to an active site. Let us see. Come on, man. Okay. Let's start an active site. So you already have a site where we're actually tracking analytics. So analytics screen, right? You're able to see how much. So how many requests are like this user wasn't actually using the site at all. So for every single minute, we're actually tracking how many requests you have made. You can go back for say 6 hours and say in that duration, in say 9:05 to 9:10, you actually use like 12 milliseconds worth of time. So like that's like nothing. So this is the idea. So we are actually showing you in analytics screen how much CPU time you're actually using. I think, does that answer the question?
The background job, like example, the backup job, it's taken new
situation. So right now we're not tracking that. The reason we're not tracking that is we can always defer the execution of background jobs by several minutes, right? The request we can't defer. So like the moment someone says, show me the page, you have to show them the page. So right now we're not actually limiting the background jobs, but in future we will. We'll allow, like we'll actually expand the usage time to accommodate the background usage time as well. So like essentially, if the same plan right now says 4 hours a day, the 4 hours a day will mean only request 4 hours.
It's a plan shared to all sites. Like example, if we have the plan for $25 users, with all sites that we created with that, or each site that will have his plan.
So it's per site. So you can have one site on $10 plan and other site on say $20 plan.
Okay.
So it's different. Those plans are for different sites because, well, you can spin up a small test site, test something, and then drop the site anyway. So
the least limit for the CPU usage rate, like example that you already said that if there's some transactions taken 1 second or 2 second, it would be not be collected as a usage rate of the CPU.
But it's still counting every single request. But some requests are really, really small. For instance, like loading a single page sometimes is like 10 millisecond job. So it won't add up really, really quickly. But yeah, we count everything still.
Okay. With the all users, right? Like example.
Yeah, all users. Even the guest users. Like if you have a website and website, other people are visiting your website, we even count those logs.
Okay.
So and by the way, we only count the visits that happen to the Frappe. So if you are, let's just say if you have images, we don't count the image loading time. If you have downloads, we again don't count download times, just the visits that come to Frappe. So it's like pretty hard to explain the segregation to someone who hasn't been programming, but like whatever actually touches Frappe is actually we are concerned about.
So you mean that you gathering all the CPU usage according to the database usage?
Yeah, it's pretty much like, yeah. If the request hits the database, we're counting that. If it doesn't, then we're not.
Okay.
But yeah, like, so right now, if you have any questions, like, you know, which plan should we use? Like pretty much go for even the smallest plan. We're being really, really lenient. Just make sure that you move as quickly as possible, right? You know, let that not be a problem in your migrations or choosing particular.
Okay.
So Ahmad is asking, our customers pay year in advance? So the currently, again, we have Faris in this meeting with us. So Faris has done the billing and...
For every site which is active for 1 day, we charge you for that 1 day. So for example, if there is a $30 site and it is active for 1 day, we'll charge you $1. And we accumulate this amount. And then at the end of the day, your card will be charged that amount.
So let's just say if you have 10 sites for 10 of your customers, your card will be charged for those.
Yeah. So I think your customer paying you is completely different. Is in your hands. So we don't care about that. You can charge them however you want. But this is how we charge the sites.
So the simple logic is the base price divided by number of days in a month.
Yes. That's no, it is 30 days.
30
no.
days flat. Yeah. And that's how your bill at the end of the day, irrespective of your CPU usage. If it is more than, then we give you alert and stuff. But minimum is base plan divided by 30 per day.
All right. Then Jignesh again asked, minor upgrades from version 12.xx to 12.yy happens automatically. Yeah. So like, exactly how you see your sites on yourreplex.com, the same functionality is underlying the system as well. So like, so on yourreplex.com as well, there is this time window that essentially says according to your site's time zone. So let's just say if your site is set to India, right? Then at Indian local time from 1 a.m. to 4 a.m., we assume that nobody is actually using the site and we perform the migrations automatically. If they fail, then we essentially revert to a previous working state. And so like you don't actually have to worry about migrations failing. So right now, if we see any migrations failing, we'll resolve the migrations on our own. Because you know we're not actually supporting customers anyway, so these are pretty much vanilla installations. But yeah, minor version upgrades happen automatically.
I have a question about that. If we need to create two application server and one database, like the architects of availability, like example, how we can do it with that?
Again, I didn't get it.
A multiple instance with the same database, one view.
Is this regarding replication? Like, do you want a replicated instance or do you want... I still don't get the point. So if you're concerned about replication, right?
Yes, I'm concerned
about replication. So in ERPnix.com as well, we provide like a hot replica of the entire server. So if something happens to your current machine, I mean, we switch on to the replica and then hopefully the users never even notice the downtime. We're using the same system under the hood here. But there is no way of, so essentially right now we're not letting customers choose whether they want extra replica or not. Like this is just whatever our infrastructure chooses under the hood for availability, that's what we're using.
Going ahead and closing this call, we'll look forward to your queries over various channels we are connected with. Thanks very much. Take care. Stay safe.